I pray that great things would happen this year in our city. Lord, I pray that you would just lead and guide this council tonight. We ask and pray all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Rick. And now, we do the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Motion and a second to approve the minutes of the special session of December 29th, 2011.
So moved.
Second. Any discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
On the order of the agenda, any change to the order of the agenda?
Mayor, firefighter Claude Philkins could not be here this evening, so we'd like to do that meeting in February.
Okay.
So that is item one to be removed.
So there's a motion to delete item number one, bill number 2012-1. Okay. Motion and a second?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Hereby start a public hearing. RE CDBG goes out on behalf of Brooksville Downtown Improvement Committee.
Okay, in 2009, the city applied for and received a $100,000 grant on behalf of the Kirksville Downtown Improvement Committee, or KDIC, for the employment of an executive director for 2 years. This is basically just a housekeeping item. We have to, in order to be eligible for more CDBG grants for the coming year, we have to close out the grant by March 15th. So they had some times in there where they did not have a director in place, so there are going to be some excess funds. Those funds will be deobligated back to the state. If there are no more legal fees or expenses to be incurred, there will be $17,171.21 deobligated back to the state. We do expect a few more invoices to come in for legal and some other things as well. But there is no fiscal impact to the city for holding this hearing.
Are there any questions or comments? None being. Hereby call the public hearing to stop. Over.
And there is a sign-in sheet that has to be, we have to have a sign-in sheet for the public hearing, so
okay.
It's being passed around.
Once you get the sheet, if you please put your name and address on that for us.
Okay, action presentations. Vicki, would you please bring bill number one?
That was removed.
She said just to change it.
Oh, did she say? Okay.
Mayor, would you like to go on ahead and read that and present
that? Go ahead and read it.
Mm-hmm.
A resolution honoring Carolyn Christman for service to the citizens of Kirksville, Missouri. Whereas Carolyn Christman has served on the city of Kirksville as a council member from April 2009 to December 2011. And whereas Carolyn Christman has displayed throughout the performance of her duties on the city council the highest standards of personal ethics and dedication. And whereas Carolyn Christman has contributed time and energy towards the betterment of the Kirksville community through her service on the City Council and several of its boards and commissions. Now, therefore, be it resolved that the City Council of the City of Kirksville does hereby extend their sincere appreciation and thanks to Carolyn Christman for her service to the community. Be it further resolved that the City Council extends their best wishes for her continued success. Passed by the City Council this 23rd day of January, 2012.
Thought you weren't
going
to have to come to any more
companies. Well, one more, right? What's that?
One, two, three. Let me take care of this.
Okay.
One, two,
three. Thank you very much. Second. Give her a good one. motion and a second on Dr. Kerwin's.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Vicki, would you read bill number two, please?
An ordinance amending chapter 14, article 2, sections 1421 and 1433 of the Code of Ordinances of the City of Kirksville, Missouri, with additions for business license testing for certain occupations.
Brad?
Yes, sir. We have talked to council about this a couple of times. This is our ordinance that we're presenting to council to test for licenses for new contractors, plumbers, and electricians in the city. We have been discussing this for quite a while. We have developed tests. We've given these tests out to different people and refined, and we think we need to determine that people that are getting a new business license for these occupations should have some minimum level of skill, and we believe that's what these tests do. It'd be important to note that anyone that would currently be a contractor or plumber or electrician, they are grandfathered in, and they do not need to take the test as long as their licenses remain current. So if this ordinance is passed tonight, someone's license from 2011 is good until the last day of February, I believe. So if they, as long as they renew by that date, they're still grandfathered in. So this would only be for new contractors or people who would let their license lapse. There is two waivers in the system. One is a waiver for anyone who is a card-carrying member of a state or national institution, like a union where a journeyman skill level would be allowed to be a waiver for the test, where an apprentice would not. Or if they do have a degree or diploma, an electrical engineering degree, or some skill that would correlate specifically to the license that's being requested, they could get a waiver for that. And this would apply to anyone in the company who would take the test. Of course, some people get their own individual licenses, and it would apply to the individual at that point. But if a company gets licensed, of course, all their employees are covered under the one license. So we think it improves public safety so that people would know that our new contractors, plumbers, electricians, do have some level of experience and some knowledge and able to be able to go to work. Our passing grade 70%, and so we've set it so that we believe that only those with very minimal knowledge would fail. If they fail a first test, they can take immediately a second test, which would be different. And if they would happen to fail that test, they have to wait 2 weeks to test again. Second, any test after the first one, there is a $10 fee for any tests. Of course, we don't let the test go out, but after a test is done, we would let them know what the correct answer is to questions, but they can't take anything with them. That'd be about it. We're hoping to see if this would satisfy the council. We think it's a good program and to help with future contractors.
Any questions or comments? Can I have a motion and a second, please?
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you. Vicki, would you please bill number three, please?
An ordinance of the City of Kirksville, Missouri, approving a lot split, which is part of a tract of land located on or near 401 East Shepherd Avenue in Kirksville, Missouri.
So moved.
Second.
This is a lot split of a tract of land that's opened by that's owned by DVRA Property Management. Michael Diak is one of the owners. He's here this evening. This resulted from a rezoning that we had down on East Shepherd Street several weeks ago. The property was rezoned to CP3, and part of that agreement, because there were issues from adjoining landowners, it was that a section of this property that they own would be split, and an adjacent landowner, Dr. Kelly Burchett, has agreed to purchase this land. The land that's being split would be landlocked, but Dr. Burchett has agreed that he would combine the land with his existing home so that it does have street frontage and would meet city requirements then for a lot split. It is zoned as CP3, planned extensive business. If the lot is not, let's see, I can't remember how many years, I believe it's 2 years. By November 21st, 2014, if no development is on the lot at that point, it reverts back to R1 and R3 residential zoning if no development takes place on this piece that's being split. So we're recommending the approval of the lot split. We believe that it does meet all city requirements. That's it.
Any questions or comments? All in favor?
Aye.
Vicki, would you please read rule number 4?
An ordinance of the City of Kirksville, Missouri, rezoning real estate located at 1023 East Jefferson Street, herein from O1P Planned Office District Zoning to CP3 Planned Extensive Business Zoning, and changing the zoning map accordingly.
So moved. Second?
So moved.
Second.
Brad. This is a rezoning request that we have had from Jay Patel, the owner, and his agent Steve Noon, who is the architect. It is, I think you have a map on your in your packets there that show the property at the corner of Jefferson and Baltimore Street. We've got a map up there on the board. It's kind of hard to see, but Baltimore is on the right and Jefferson Street is at the bottom. I might get up there just for a second. But this is, they've applied for rezoning as a convenience store. This is the existing overhead, canopy that's there that would be removed. The store location will be here at the Checkers. This is the property right here. This would all be parking and drive. This would be store. This would be grass. And there'd be fences here for privacy. This went before the Planning and Zoning Commission as a public hearing. No person spoke in opposition to the rezoning. The layout that you see does meet all the setback requirements. And the building, the parking lot, has enough parking space. The entrances are remaining the same where they are today. If it would be approved, they would have to meet stormwater requirements, and we would see what they need for signage and get their permits. The lighting would be designed to reduce glare or carry over to adjacent properties. The west side and about half of the north side will have a privacy fence to as a shield or barrier against other residential properties. And the hours of operation are expected to be approximately 8 a.m. until 10 p.m. at night, so it will not be a 24-hour store, but that's not a requirement. That's what they told us they intend to do. We don't see any problem with their site plan. Again, Planning and Zoning has recommended it to Council. Would you have any questions?
They're not going to sell gasoline.
That's correct. It is just it's called Express Mart. It is a chain of 7 or 8. I don't know about their other stores, but this store would not sell gasoline, just be a little grocery type convenience store. So what most convenience stores sell. I'm assuming they probably sell packaged alcohol and some food items and the pop type stuff and normal things.
Thank you, Brett. Any questions or comments? All in favor?
Aye.
Vicki, would you please do a motion and a second to approve an agreement with Missouri Rural Enterprise Innovation Center Incorporated doing business as Merrick for an economic development partnership, including office space and administrative assistance.
So moved.
Melanie?
I'm here today to ask you to approve an agreement with the Missouri Rural Enterprise and Innovation Center, better known as Merrick to us, for an economic development partnership that will include office space and administrative assistance. As you know, we've all been working towards a one-stop shop for economic development that will be located at 315 South Franklin Street, and this is one of the next steps in the process. This agreement would provide office space, including building maintenance, janitorial services, snow removal, and utilities, excluding telephone. It would also provide partial compensation for an administrative assistant that will provide service for Merrick as well as K-Ready and KDIC that will also be located at that facility. The fiscal impact, the city would commit to $7,500 towards the salary of the administrative assistant as well as the cost of the maintenance on that building, which is estimated at about $22,000 per year.
Any questions or comments? All in favor?
Aye.
Motion and second to approve a three-year agreement with Northeast Missouri Economic Development Incorporated doing business as K-Ready for Economic Development and Services.
So moved. Second.
I'm here to ask you to approve a new three-year agreement with the Northeast Missouri Economic Development Incorporated, better known as K-Ready for Economic Development Services. We started our partnership with K-Ready in 2003, and previous to that, the city had provided the economic development for services for our area. The city has provided traditionally financing of $100,000 per year, and that's been for the last 9 years. And this request, this contract would actually keep that financial assistance the same. It would also include, as I mentioned with the Merrick, partial compensation for an administrative assistant that will provide assistance to K-Ready. One big change would be that instead of two members on the K-Ready board, the new agreement would be expanded to four members. And the K-Ready board has approved this agreement, so we're here tonight to ask you to approve it. The fiscal impact would be obviously that $100,000 commitment each year for the term of the contract, plus the $7,500 for the administrative assistant and the building expenses for that location.
Any questions or comments? All in favor?
Aye.
Motion and second to approve a bid from Love Green Ford, Kirksville, Missouri, for the purchase of three 2012 police vehicles and subsequent trade of two retired cars.
So moved. Second.
This is an annual request, fairly consistent with years past. A couple of items that are somewhat different. Our intent is to keep one of the black and white vehicles that normally would get traded in and use it as a detective vehicle. It won't be quite as undercover as we would like it to be, but by the time we get done with it, it'll be serviceable in that regard. That will be replacing a vehicle that's 12 years old with over 100,000 miles on it and is rusting out, so it needs to be replaced, and John and his staff will not be sorry to see it go. We're requesting that the bid, that it be provided to Love Greens. We are going with a different type of vehicle, which is somewhat different. This happens every 4, 5, 6, 7 years that some maker of a police package vehicle will go out of the police package business or change to another type of vehicle for a police package. And that's what's going to happen with the Chevys next year. So we knew it was going to happen at some point, which is why we put out a broad bid this year, and that the Dodges came in as the most economical choice. And we were going to have to change out our equipment anyway, whether it was this year or next year, so that we just are going to do it 1 year earlier and hopefully stay with the Dodges as we have with the Chevys and did the Fords prior to that time. Again, one other thing that might be a little bit unusual is when you take everything into account, you have a bid tabulation sheet, and you always hope that this is comparing apples to apples, and that's not always the case because sometimes you have to spend some money here to paint cars or a little bit difference as far as the trade is concerned. So when you put all things into consideration to put the cars into a serviceable condition, Love Greens, the local bidder, would have been about $330 over the next closest bidder, but that falls well within the local preference, and so that we then convert back to Love Greens and ask that the bid be awarded to Love Greens for three police package vehicles for this year.
Any questions or comments? All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you, Jim. Motion and a second to authorize the city manager to have improvements made to truck number 506 by Felton Fire of Carroll, Iowa, to replace the electric or hydraulic valves with manual valves. So, Randy. Second.
We got to looking at valves. We were replacing about $4,000 a valve, and we got four valves not working right now. And I said, hold it, we got to figure out a different way to approach this problem with these hydraulic valves. And so we had Public Works garage people on us. We met with the Akron valve company representative. And so instead of having a hydraulic where you turn a little switch on and it activates a little electric motor that opens a valve hydraulically, we're going back to what all of our fire trucks have is a manual pull. You pull the handle and it opens the valve. No electronics, no hydraulics. It's all manual, and we haven't had problems with them and all, any of our other fire trucks. And that's why we're requesting to do away with the hydraulic over electric valves that we keep having problems with.
Have any other fire departments had these issues?
This is a truck that we purchased out in Buffalo, the ladder truck, and I think they had money to spend and thought it was a pretty cool deal, and it happened to come with the truck, and we thought it was going to be all right. They said there was no problems, but we're finding out different on the hydraulic over electric valves. Maybe we've used it more than they used it.
So, any questions or comments? All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you, Randy. Motion and a second to approve the bid from Lovering Ford for 2012 1.5-ton single axle Ford F550 truck with a dump bed and snow plow.
So moved. Second.
Okay. This is a motion to replace one of our six primary snow route vehicles. Unit 277, the vehicle we're replacing, is actually a 2006 F-350 truck. That truck and chassis is too small for the mission that we ask it to do. We're bidding for an F-550. We received four bids. They're all for Ford trucks with a variety of plows. The low bid was from Love Green Ford with the optional block heater. It would be $67,429. We have $55,100 in the budget for replacement of this. The expected trade-in value of this truck is $12,000 to $15,000 of resale value. However, our recommendation is that we do not replace Unit 279, our lift truck, until this vehicle is replaced and 277 sold, so we know exactly how much we have. This truck will not be in for this snow season. There is about a 90 to 120 day build and delivery time on it. So we'll see this truck plowing snow in 2012 fall.
Any questions or comments? All in favor?
Aye.
Thank you, John. Now, motion and second to approve the purchase of water treatment chemicals for various vendors.
So moved.
Second.
We bid nine different chemicals that we use at the water treatment plant, and in this instance, we are recommending the low bidder for each of these chemicals. Most significantly is we have a new bidder for powdered activated carbon, which is over 18% less than what we paid for that chemical in the previous year, which makes everything balance out so we don't have a huge increase in chemical costs. We checked with a number of other companies that use this firm because that is such a large part of our treatment process, and came back with fine reports, so we're recommending Standard Purification as a supplier for that, as well as the low bidder on the other chemicals. There are three additional chemicals that I put in the report for your review. Where we don't actually take bids on the same timeline, we have a multi-year agreement with the suppliers of these chemicals because they typically come with a vending system or a like the ammonia system and so on for the sodium chloride. So again, all of the chemicals, both the nine bid on this bid and the other three, we anticipate that our demand this year will come in under the dollars budgeted.
Any questions or comments?
Any thoughts about, there's quite a wide variety of
chemical costs in some cases can be a large bit of difference. Any idea why some can do it so much cheaper than others?
Part of it is, quite frankly, a question of how far are they transporting the material, because transport costs are included in here. Some of them, I think, we have purchased from Brentag in the past, and then the last year they didn't get the bid, Hawkins did, and this year they offered a very nice bid package, and in fact, Brentag won on everything they bid. For us, that's really good. They're the low bidder. They're a trusted supplier, and we only have to deal with one. But
transportation,
I think, is probably one of the largest factors.
Any other questions or comments? All in favor?
Aye.
Motion and second to approve the bid for Wind Water at Blue Springs, Missouri, for fire hydrants, valve boxes, and traffic repair kits. So moved. Second.
Okay, we bid 30 hydrants and accessories this year. We purchase hydrants for our own use, as well as we sell hydrants to developers and other contractors who are working on extensions for the city's water distribution system. Bottom line is, Wind Water out of Blue Springs is a low bidder. We recommend award of the contract to Wind Water.
Any questions or comments? All in favor?
Aye.
Motion and second to approve the bid for Walson Construction Incorporated to perform pipeline bores in 2012. So moved. Second.
John. Okay, each year we solicit bids from typically local contractors for doing borings for us, so we have a price established as we go into the construction season to bore water lines where that is the better practice versus open cut. Last year, we spent about just under $10,000 for bores. This year, we would anticipate we'll spend $15,000 to $20,000, depending on the nature of the projects. Lawson was the only bidder, and we recommend awarding the contract to Lawson Construction Company. They are local.
Any questions or comments? All in favor?
Aye.
Motion and second to approve the bid from Wind Water Supply of Blue Springs, Missouri. Is that what we just did?
Nope, this is a different one.
For pipes, valves, and fittings for water main construction and repair. So moved. Second.
Okay. We also bid the pipes, fittings, valves, clamps, all of the things that we use in the construction of water systems, as well as the maintenance of our water system, except hydrants. They're bid separately because we have a different pool of bidders. We received six different bids. The low aggregate bid was from Wind Water. The way we advertised it was basically it would be the low aggregate bid for the entire pool of materials. So we are recommending award of this contract, which includes over 10,000 feet of pipe to Blue Springs Wind Water.
Any questions or comments? All in favor?
Aye.
Motion and second to approve the purchase of rock from Fountain Trucking Company of Kirksville. Second.
Okay, each year we take bids for the various rock that we would use. Part of this is paid for from the street department for use in street repairs. We also use part of this rock in the utility maintenance division for bedding, as well as other repairs on water lines. So this contract is actually split between those two. We also ordered this year in the contract, we took bids on what's called shot rock. That's rock about this big around that's used for erosion control for some of the storm drainage projects that we intend to do in-house. For the type of rock that we bid this year versus what we bid last year, we saw about a 3.4% increase in price. That's about what we expected. The low bidder of the three was Fountain Trucking. He was low not only in aggregate, but for each of the individual rocks. So we recommend award of this bid to Fountain Trucking.
Any questions or comments? All in favor?
Aye.
Motion and second to approve the reappointment of Ken Shook, Cole Woodcox, and Philip Biston on the Historic Preservation Commission for a 3-year term. So moved.
Three.
Second.
The Kirksville Historic Preservation Commission was established in 2009. All three of these gentlemen served at the beginning, the inception of this commission, and they're completing their first 3-year term. They've all agreed to continue serving and would like to be reappointed to an additional 3-year term.
If I'm moving on to do it. All in favor?
Aye.
Motion and second to confirm the city manager's appointment of Bert Beard to fill a vacancy on the Kirksville Industrial Development Authority, term ending June 2012. So moved.
Second.
This is a vacancy that we have been trying to fill for some time. The requirements for this particular appointment, they have to be a taxpayer. You know, there's certain things that requirements that we were having difficulty finding someone who met those requirements, who was also willing to serve. Bert Beard is active on K-Ready, and so he has agreed to fill that position. I know that it says it's till June 2012, but we will be coming back again asking to reappoint him for another term.
He's indicated he's willing to.
He's willing to serve.
Any questions or comments? All in favor?
Aye.
Vicki, reading of bills and adopting on first reading. Motion and second.
An ordinance amending Chapter 14, Article 2, Sections 1421 and 1433 of the Code of Ordinances of the City of Kirksville, Missouri, with additions for business license testing for certain occupations. An ordinance of the City of Kirksville, Missouri, approving a lot split, which is part of a tract of land located on or near 401 East Shepherd Avenue in Kirksville. An ordinance of the City of Kirksville, Missouri, rezoning real estate located at 1023 East Jefferson Street, herein from O1P Planned Office District Zoning to CP3 Planned Extensive Business Zoning, and changing the zoning map accordingly.
Motion second.
So moved.
Second. All in favor?
Aye.
Council, is there any council comments?
Mayor, council, I do want to take just a minute and have Melanie introduce someone to you all.
Yeah, I would like to introduce George Allen. He is our intern for economic development. He is a political science major from Truman, and he will be interning for the rest of the semester. So be sure to listen.
Welcome aboard.
Thank you.
Now we will adjourn to executive session. Vicki?
Yes, I'll take the roll call. Councilmember Mills?
Aye.
And Mayor Buckley?
Aye.
Councilmember Ives?
Aye.
And Councilmember Edge?
Aye.
I declare this council meeting open.